Welcome to topNotch tutorials. Today we are going to learn about median filters. In the previous tutorials, we have seen the application of low pass filters and high pass filters using neighborhood processing techniques. Here, I will brush up again on how low pass filters and high pass filters conceptually work. Suppose this is my image. This spot over here is the main portion of the image, while these wavy lines are the background. If I use a low pass filter, entire background will be retained in the output image, but the main or the high frequency component, as we call it, which is the main part of the of any image, will not be retained in the output. Whereas if I use a high pass filter, this main portion of the image, which is a high frequency component, will be retained in the output and the background will be flushed out. That was about low pass filters and high pass filters working individually with their specific properties. But what if there is a peculiar type of noise in the image? Let's take the same image as an example. Here you can see that there are small fine spots in between which are dark and a few hollow circles. I have drawn this to show to represent a special type of noise, which is called salt and pepper noise. Salt and pepper, as the name suggests, these dark dots which are in the image are the pepper noise, because they are like a pepper that we all know. They represent the lowest frequency or the lowest intensity pixels or lowest intensity entities in the image, and these hollow circles are the salt noise, which as the name suggests, like salt, they have the highest intensity. Now, even if we use a low pass filter, the entire main part of the image would as it is vanish, but the also this pepper noise will also vanish because it is high frequency component, but this salt noise will be retained because it is a low frequency component along with the background. Now, using a high pass filter, again the main part of the image or the main image will be retained, the background will be flushed out, and also the salt noise, but the pepper noise will be retained because it is a high frequency component. Now, in such situations, both the high pass filter and low pass filters can't be used individually, so we have to come up with a new type of filter, which is a median filter. Low pass filters and high pass filters have masks. We use these masks to impose them on the main image, and we use the neighborhood processing techniques. But a median filter doesn't require a mask. The working of a median filter is pretty much, or it's blandly based upon the mathematical concept of medians. Consider this f of x comma y, a spatial domain representation of an image. Here, this zero value pixel is the pepper noise, that is low intensity noise, and this 100 is the salt noise, the high intensity or the high frequency component. Now, to use the median filtering technique, we simply arrange, or we simply take down all the pixel values separately, like 0, 30, 45, 50, 100, 55, 60, 10, 90. Now, having written down this all the pixel intensity values, we will arrange them in ascending order or descending order. I will arrange them in an ascending order for now. So 0, 10, then 30, 45, 50, 55, 60, 90, 100. Now, having arranged them in ascending order, there are 9 elements. So The middlemost element will be my median, which is 50. I have four elements over here, four elements on this side. So this is my median. I simply take this pixel value as 50 and it is the median, and my median filter output will be simply like this. Drawing the 3x3 spatial domain representation of an image, and I will simply replace every pixel intensity value, that is 0, 30, 45 and so on, with a single value 50, because it is the median. So every intensity of all of each pixel will become 50, and this will be my output, median filtered output. That was all about 3x3 matrix and using a median filter on it. But what if we have a bigger matrix? Then we concentrate, or we break that matrix into 3x3 portions, or the smallest portions. As for this 8x8 matrix, I have broken down the image into 3x3 small matrices. I will concentrate over this matrix first. Now, to apply median filtering over here, I will arrange all the elements in ascending order or the descending order, as I have said, any order will do. Then we take the centermost element, which is 100. Four over here and four over here. So 100 is my median. Now I will simply take this 100 and replace it all over the portion that we considered in the parent image, and thus we have a median filtered image, or a portion of this image has been median filtered. Now, as per the custom of neighborhood processing, we will proceed by just next considering this small 3x3 portion or patch of matrix, and again arranging all the elements in ascending order, and then calculating the median and replacing all the pixel intensities with that particular median intensity value. So this was all about median filtering.